Okay, hey guys, so welcome back. I know my hair is just tossed up. I washed my face because I didn't think I'd have time for this video, but I have a little bit of time. So I'm gonna do a full affordable face for you guys. And I've got quite a bit of stuff here. I know I just did that Sephora haul, which stay tuned because I'm gonna update you guys on some of that stuff. So I'm filming this a little bit later in the day. You can probably tell by the shadows in the background. But I'm excited to try some of these products out because I got a few different things in. Like this Catrice Liquid Coverage Foundation. I haven't tried this in so long. I got this in PR. I'm pretty sure it said it was like reformulated. I'm gonna have to go take a quick look. Figure out what it was talking about. If I even have the PR sticker at this point. But I haven't tried it in so long. I figured I'd give it a go. I'm so excited about this. And Charlie Brown, like say less. This showed up at my door. I had no idea it was coming. And I was like, oh my God, that's the cutest thing I've ever seen. And then I saw these little light bulb pillows at Target for $20. I have to show you guys a picture here. I took a picture because I was like, that is so cute. I don't know what we would use the lighted pillows for other than Christmas, but they are so cute. They have them there if you're interested. But I'm super excited about it. This has like a ton of stuff in here. So we're gonna like just dive into that. If you're interested in seeing a bunch of affordable products, let's go ahead and dive on into it. I'm gonna share with you skincare that is affordable and like so insanely good. But honestly, you have to go read the Amazon reviews because if you read the Amazon reviews, you'll get it. It has like 5 stars, like 2,000 reviews. It's amazing. And I do want to say thank you so much to Goodall for sponsoring today's video. I am so excited that they decided to work with me again because this is a great vitamin C serum if you're looking for something that's more affordable, because vitamin C serums get so expensive. I've paid well over $100 for one before. I shared this with you guys when I was in Georgia. It's the Vitamin C Green Tangerine Dark Spot Serum from Goodall. And I love this stuff. You can't even see how much I've used of it because of packaging. So a little bit goes a long way. It has a different consistency than a lot of other vitamin C serums that I have tried. So you can see right there, it's kind of just that like jelly consistency, but I really like this one. It's a cooling sensation. It smells really good. It's a very hydrating product. So what makes this one different from other vitamin C's is, first of all, the price. The price is insane. It's definitely more affordable than other vitamin C's that I have tried. The texture is different. It has that like jelly consistency. Like I said, it kind of feels like a primer, but it sits really well on my skin and I have very oily skin. So what also makes this different is that it has 70% green tangerine in here. So if you don't know, green tangerine is a natural source of vitamin C. Vitamin C is something great to incorporate into your skin. It's going to help keep you plumped, hydrated, smooth, and just evened out. And it's one of those things that you have to keep using and using over time to really see those results. You can't like use it one time and be like, oh, it's done. You got to keep using it and keep keeping it in your skincare routine. You can use this AM and PM as well. This is the other product that I've tried from them. They sent it to me a few weeks ago, so it's really new for me, but this is the Vita-C Dark Spot Care. This is the cream. So this one's the serum, this one's the cream. This one's so different. I don't think I've tried anything like this before. If I have, it has to be like years ago. But I'm gonna try to show you, I might have to do a different close-up, but there's little capsules in here. You see those little specks? So those are little capsules of vitamin C, and this is gonna leave like a more dewy finish, which I like as well. But again, oh, it smells so good. It just smells like a spa. So all you do is just take it on your fingers and you're going to just rub this into your skin. It is such a hydrating product. It feels so good. It really does feel luxurious. Also, like I said, this one had 70% of that green tangerine in there. This one has 67%. And this also has 4% niacinamide in there as well. So I love the packaging of this. They're super affordable and great to put into your skincare routine. I will have a link down below where you guys can shop their products up to 40% off, which I think is an even better deal. Like, that's just crazy to me. I'll have a link right below in the description box you guys can click. Again, thank you so much to Goodall for sponsoring this video. I love these. These are awesome if you're looking for, again, more affordable skincare with that vitamin C. I'm not gonna do any primer because we have those two on, and honestly, I feel like it just primes the skin and like makeup sits on top of it really well. We're gonna dive in to these. So I got these e.l.f. I got this one. You guys have probably seen it. This is the Halo Glow Liquid Filter, but I got the Tan Deep for like bronzer, but I finally saw the shade Medium in store, and I am so excited to try this on my skin because it looks like it has really good coverage. So I'm going to use this first, and then I'm going to go on top of it with this Catrice product. Okay, so I'm going to apply this all over kind of like I would a foundation or a primer, really, I guess. I just want to see like the coverage of it. I mean, I'm sure if I went with the like sponge, it would be even better coverage, but it definitely has some in there. And it does give you a really radiant look. Like, look at that. That's actually really nice. It's definitely accentuating my texture and like my pores. But I think when we go in with something matte on top, we should be fine. All right, I think we're gonna go in with Honey Beige. So I'm just gonna actually drip it down my face. So again, this is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage. Lasts up to 24 hours. It said it's mattifying. It's been so long. Wow. Hold on, let me spread this out. This is the Huda Beauty Buff and Build brush that I got in my haul that I showed you guys last time. Wow. I feel like that just has good coverage. I'm kind of just pressing it in. Honestly, I could skip the like outer perimeters of my face and just hit the center because that e.l.f. Halo Glow really made me glowy. All right, I'm looking very, very glowy. Now I'm a little nervous. I'm a little nervous, but like I think with when I set it with powder, it won't be as bad. And maybe some concealer too. But since we're on the Halo Glow route, I'm gonna take again this tan deep color and we're just gonna do some bronzing. Work this out. I guess we're gonna just be glowing tonight, which luckily, I mean, we're only at home, so it's not like we're going anywhere, but I'm excited to dive into this Peanuts collection. I have two concealers. I have the Flower Beauty Light Illusion, and then I have the Revlon 5-in-1. I thought I had a Milani one, don't I? I can't find it. I've let Madison come in here as I get ready, and my floor below me is a disaster, but it's fun. It's worth it. Santa, I think, is gonna bring her a little cute little vanity from Melissa and Doug. I cannot wait to see her play with that. I like the Flower Beauty. I think I've tried the Revlon one and it didn't have as much coverage as I wanted like in the inner corner. And that Flower Beauty one just always does such a good job for me. So I always usually go back to it. Now I will say one of my favorite foundations is the CoverGirl Outlast. The 3-in-1 with the red cap. That one is so good. So if you didn't want to try this out, that CoverGirl one is amazing. Now I'm going to go in with the Revlon Candid Photo Ready Powder. This is a great Peach Perfect dupe if that's something you're looking for. It is so nice. I love it. And we're just going to set everything and make us matte. We're going to mattify. Like, look at this. It's such a good powder. So here is the entire, I think, Peanut collection. So we have eyeshadow, eyeliner, lip gloss, lipstick, face products. Pumped about this because the blushes look amazing and so do the highlighters. And I love Milani's Wet n Wild's highlighters. I have this one too still that I just love from them because it's so good. You have the Good Grief proof eyeliner, waterproof eyeliner. I usually like their eyeliners too, so I'm pumped about that. This is the Merry Christmas Charlie Brown palette. So here's the palette. And you have a red lipstick and a lip gloss. Which I would honestly probably never wear these, nor would I buy them, but it's a, like glitter red lip and then a very shimmery gloss. I might try the gloss today. Because usually if I don't use it, I like to, you know, give it away. So I don't want to like use something I'm not going to ever use again. You know what I mean? Little Snoopy's Doghouse makeup sponge case. That is like so cute. Then these adorable sponges with Snoopy. Oh my gosh. Eyelash curler with a little Snoopy keychain. Have some nail files and nail stickers, and these are just adorable. We're gonna dive into, let's finish off our face. I think that would be easiest. So one of my favorite bronzers I've been using at the moment has been this CoverGirl True Blend line. This is a So Flushed pan. I don't know. They also have blushes and I love their blushes in this too. Bronzer in here. My nose. And then we're going to go into this Peanuts Wet n Wild The Gift of Giving palette. So you have two blushes and two highlighters. I'm going to go in with this blush. Oh, that's pretty. Okay, I'm going to use the light pink one on the other side. Just see what it looks like. Oh, I like the light pink one a little bit more. I don't know. I've been really loving like that subtle the pop of pink on my cheeks. It's my favorite. I don't know what it is, but I've just been loving pops of pink. So these are pretty, very like easy to wear. I feel like they're not gonna be like too in your face. Now we're gonna go in with these highlighters. Oh no, this one just looks like a dud. And then you have the gold one, so I think I'm gonna go in with the dud first and just see. Do the gold. Yeah, the gold is way better. I just don't love a gold highlighter on me. Kind of stinks. Like, the gold highlighter is good if you like gold highlighters, but like the other one, the one that I was kind of like most excited about is a dud. The blushes are good, but with 2 out of 4 not working, it kind of stinks. I hate that. But I'm going to show you this Wet n Wild one. What was this called? This was the loose highlighter powder in Moon Tears. This is their loose highlighter. I don't even remember it. This came out forever ago, but it is a giant highlighter that you only need the smallest amount. Look at that. Like Wet n Wild. We need more of that right there. Now that we've kind of had like one dud, I'm really hoping this is not all duds, to be honest with you. So we're going into the Merry Christmas Charlie Brown palette, the eyeshadow palette. And I'm going to try to, there we go. Ooh, they're so cute, like stamped with the characters. Okay, I'm just gonna do what I normally do where I like kind of dive in and try different things and then I'll come back and give you a review, and but you can watch me apply it. So we'll do that now. Just got them on my eyes. First off, this Juvia's Place. These lashes are so good from this brand. They're more on the affordable side as well. You can get them at Ulta. This is the maximum volume ones. This is like the third pair I've tried from this brand and I absolutely love them. I'll have them linked below. Like I said, I picked mine up in store at Ulta, but it just, it brings the whole look to life. This eyeshadow palette. So it's interesting because the color story is just like all over the place, and I guess I accidentally dabbled into this when I was going into this mauve color, and that's why I kind of ended up going a little bit more smoky because this got into my crease. The color story is really all over the place. There are some gems though, like this shimmer is gorgeous. I feel like this, that is beautiful. Like, these two right here are just going to be straight up glitters. So it's one of those things where what I did is I just kind of like dug my finger in here. Not dug, but I really kind of got that product on my finger. Then I tapped it on my makeup towel, my dingy makeup towel, and then put it on my eyes. That way I don't have a ton of fallout. And I feel like that helped. And then I went with my face sponge and kind of dusted a little bit of it up. The color story is kind of just all over the place, but there are some really pretty shimmers in here. Anyways, I do like the eyeshadow palette. Would I go out and buy it necessarily? No. I mean, maybe for that shimmery green I would. That was stunning just there. But I wouldn't necessarily go out of my way to buy that. The eyeliner is so good though. Like for that chunky glitter liner to be on my lid and the eyeliner to go over it, it's a brush tip. It's very black and it honestly just glided right over it. Like that was a hit. That was one of my favorites. Lash curler curled my lashes really well as well. Sometimes these eyelash curlers are a dud, but that one was really nice and I enjoyed that one. I'm gonna go in with this lip liner. This is JCat Beauty in 218 Mauve. There's a few different lip products that I love, but I want to go in with this Maybelline New York Color Sensational Matte Lipstick. This is in the color 699, more buff. I also love these NYX Lingerie Liquid Lips. Oh, they're so good. It's just a pretty, pretty color too. This one just is not as transfer proof as the NYX one. This one's like not transfer proof at all. But it feels so comfortable. It reminds me, I actually tried a MAC lipstick today. That feels very similar to this. So, I mean, that could be a dupe right there. Their gloss. Okay, let me try the gloss that they have in the collection. This is the Wet n Wild Peanuts Very Merry Lip Gloss. It is very shimmery. Can you see that? I have a feeling this doesn't have, like, a color to it, really. So, you're still going to see my lip color, but then this on top. Oh, a little bit of color there. It gives a really pretty shine to the lips. Makes them look juicier and plump. But again, would I go out and buy just that? No, probably not. So if I had to say the things from the peanut collection that I would get just for like the cuteness of it, this, I'm gonna be putting my sponges in this. I mean, it is so cute. The little doghouse. I don't know. I think I would pass on this. It's not as intense as I would hope. I feel like Wet n Wild has such good blushes and highlighters too that I'm surprised that that palette's not like an all over win for me. I personally would not repurchase this Catrice product. I would just go with the CoverGirl Extreme Wear foundation that I love, which I'll leave again that link below. But it's just so full coverage and it looks beautiful on the skin. And even though I did use this e.l.f. Halo Glow, I feel like this just, I don't know, I just have that makeup gut feeling that me and this one wouldn't mesh, and maybe that's why I don't use it anymore. This though, I will still use this as bronzer. This one I would just use as a mixer. I wouldn't put it all over my face like I did today because that was so glowy. And even though I feel like I have a good radiance going right now, I wouldn't do it again, to be honest with you. And this powder is always a win. This is just such a good drugstore powder. You've got to try it out. But anyways, I think that is everything in this video that I need to try. I was mostly excited for that Peanuts collection, and of course it was hits and misses, but I do like the way my makeup turned out. I feel like if you add a lash, babe, it's gonna come together at some point. Anyway, that's all I have to show you guys today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.